We're going to answer a few of the questions that you put on the reflection form. We're then going to focus on continuous round robin because there are many variations of round robin. And the one that I think best fits into Nexus will be the continuous round robin. So we'll be talking about that one. You'll then get an opportunity to practice this structure with your team. So I've got a few questions on the reflection, and somebody said, how can I clearly explain a structure to students for the first time? More than one person said this, and obviously it is new, so maybe you're not feeling 100% confident. If you go onto Shared Drive, the cooperative learning has been shared with everybody, I put a video for every single structure. Along with my videos, there are also videos from other members of staff, from you. So feel free to show that video to your learners if you don't feel confident or if you just want to. So, or you can use the coaching sheet that you've got for every structure that you should have a printout of. You can use that as you introduce a structure. Absolutely fine. If you've lost your copies on the drive, under the resources, you can print off everything that I use is there, and you can just print off what you like. Another question was, if I have 17 learners and I want to do groups, should I have lots of threes, one, five, what should I do? If you're deciding to group with teams, your main objective is to get fours. You want to go for the fours first, fill up your fours, and then you can turn it into fives, or you can have a three. You don't want to have lots of threes, and you don't want to have lots of fives. So fill up your fours, and then the rest make a five or three. Another question was, what is a good structure for questioning? Because a lot of the ones we've looked at are for listening. But for encouraging questioning is a structure called fan and pick, and that will be coming up soon. Okay, so we will focus on that soon. So as we've touched on before, whenever we use the word robin, it's a spoken structure, and table is a written structure. And round means that we are no longer working in a pair, we are now working in a team of four. And this structure can be done at a table, but you can also do it standing up, you can do it anywhere. But instead of using a two, you can use a four, you can also use a three or a five. Structure that we are going to focus on is the continuous round robin. And with a continuous round robin, we'll watch the video in a moment, you raise a question and then the learners have got a chance to answer this question, so they go round. The reason that we want to do continuous, if you say we're going to do a round robin, so what's your name lots of colours? Blue, red, yellow, pink. This team may finish before the other teams, and then you've got your class management issues. With a continuous round robin, you will give a time. We'll go over this in a moment. So for 1 minute, you're going to do a continuous round robin. It means that the team will go round and round and round, and your whole class will finish at the same time. So that's why we're going to focus on continuous for class management. If you only have a group of four and you're doing a small focus group, like I know Ruby does, then you could just do, okay, we're going to do a round robin and each person gives you one answer because you have control of this table. But with a whole class situation, I'd highly recommend going for continuous. So when you do a continuous round robin, first of all, the name of the structure is announced. So today we're going to do a continuous round robin. The question is stated, so I this week use what is a debate. The think time is given, like we always do, so you would do this if you wish, or you can do longer. The learners are told who starts, so learner three, you will start. The length of time is stated, you will be doing this for 1 minute or maybe 30 seconds, it's up to you. You start the timer, the rotation begins. Okay, so what I also have introduced is the ping pong ball. So you should all have a ping pong ball in your, on your table. The reason I have the ping pong ball is so that the learners, we used this before, know whose turn it is, and so that you can just use that. So when you're using the prompt sheet, you can say, okay, so learner three is starting, you have the ping pong ball. And then you just pass that, they can pass that around. You do need to be specific, and you'll see this on the video when you see it later. Do you want a list or do you want a long answer? Because yesterday I said, what is a debate? And I was very aware that one of the learners had the ping pong ball and spoke for 45 seconds and the other three didn't get a turn. So do you want a list or do you want long answers? If you want long answers, we'll look at a different variation, but really, you just want quick answers to brainstorm ideas. Did you have another question?
That was the question.
Okay, so what we're going to do, while I sort out the technology as well, you have on your table the coaching role cards, and three of you will be the learners, and one of you will be the teacher. And if you just have a go, it's really better if you do stand up as a teacher, say the name of the structure, continuous round robin, and have a go at doing this. Questions that you could ask could be anything, so name your favourite colours, name your favourite food, those kind of things. So if you just do a list for now, does anyone have any questions before you practice? No, fantastic, okay. So I'm going to give you 4 minutes to do this within your teams. Everybody's got the coaching cards and the ping pong ball. And you can still do it in your teams.
Okay. What shall we do?
Continuous round robin. So you're going to give your idea, pass on the ball, and keep going for 1 minute. If you can't think of anything to say, you can say pass, or you can repeat what somebody else said. Okay? So your 1 minute starts now.
So basically, it's like a choose group set together. One person, 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 one
I use this, we're about to do debates in language arts, so I really did this as a pre-assessment just to see what they already knew. Okay. On reflection of looking at how that went yesterday, what you can do and what I think it turned into is a timed round robin. These are the variations. With a timed round robin, you will say that each learner has, for example, 15 seconds, 30 seconds to speak, and then it goes on to the next learner. Now, I think that would have been more effective for yesterday because my learners were talking, rather than giving a list. So the difference with a timed round robin is you allocate a certain amount of time for each learner. For that, you really would need a timer for each table so they can set it for 30 seconds. Or you can do it. Okay, now learner one, you've got 30 seconds to speak. Now learner two, three, four, and they all get their say. The single round robin, like we've already spoken about, the issue is you just need to be working with one group, not with a whole class. We've looked at the continuous. Now think right round robin. This requires more thinking skills. What happens is you will give the question, just like we did, and then the learners are going to write their answer down. So you give them, for example, 2 minutes to write down on their whiteboard their answer. And then they've got time, pass the ping pong ball around, to share their answer.
Yeah. What did you do in that moment of knowing that only one child had spoken in the round robin? Did you change the...
When only one, yesterday...
You knew that not everyone had shared, did you change
so
it right then?
Basically, you can continue the time. You can say, okay, we're now going to do this for 2 minutes, or you can say, right, now we're going to do, and then you change it to the timed round robin, so each of them get the chance. And that's the joy of it, the beauty of it. You're not restricted. If you can see that that's what's happening, you can stop. And that's why on reflection of yesterday, I was like, okay, I need to say, do we want a list or do we want a long answer? And the learners need to know that.
On a note, when you mentioned about the timing, I don't have any beads at Daiso. But Daiso sells some mini timers for cooking to fine grade it. And look at particularly this magnet, it costs, so if you have 5 or 6 tables, it costs you
That's a really good suggestion.
They are like little apple shaped as well, which is very cute. And if you want, I can even do the shopping for you ladies if you want. Because I love that, so it's cheap.
Okay, so you've got all the variations there. But like I say, with a continuous round robin, you've got your whole class operating at the same time. So that's the one that we're particularly going to focus on. So times that you can use it, if you were doing it for team building, that I put some ideas for you there. Talk about TV shows, ways to spend money, academic, facts, colours and numbers in a foreign language, possible pauses, predictions, adjectives. And a question that was raised by this table was, oh, but you know, we want to see what the learners are saying, can it be written down, what's the evidence? That could be your next activity. That you can do an activity leading from this, but this is really just to generate ideas. And like I said, right at the beginning of the workshops, if you think back to, a lot of you use the lolly sticks, which is absolutely great, but what it means is it gives every learner a chance to hear other people's ideas before you call upon them. And I added, as you heard on the video, the fact that the learners can say pass or repeat. And that's specifically for the EAL, because even if they're repeating somebody's idea, at least they're saying something. So don't penalise a group for repeating, because they're speaking, and they've also, they've magpied an idea. Up and somebody also wrote, what do I do if there's an odd number? Remember, I talk about the tunnel or the funnel, whatever you want to talk, and then that learner comes down here, they either pair up or they'll be with you. Perfect. We are going to do a rally robin. Your question is, how would you use a round robin in your class? It's a rally robin, and we're going to start with the person whose back is nearest to that wall. This is your think time. You have 30 seconds. Thank you.